This video clip will familiarize you with a couple of enhancements of the profile. First, we'll give details of how the identical building material fills no longer merge in profiles. You can see a cladding wood profile in the section window. Select it, and with a right click, select the Edit Selected Complex Profile command from the context menu. The Profile Manager opens now. In the Profile Editor window, select the fill of the profile and using the multiply function, create 5 copies of the profile above each other. Click on the Store Profile button to save the modified profile and close the Profile Manager dialog. You'll notice the profile has not merged the separate but connected identical fills and has kept their contour lines. Let's see another enhancement of profiles now. You can see a composite wall in the floor plan. Select the wall, right-click, and choose the Edit Selected Composite from the context menu to open the Composite Wall Settings dialog. The end lines of the airspace are unchecked, so they're hidden in the floor plan and in the section window as well. Click OK to leave this dialog. Let's convert this composite wall to a profile wall. Select the wall and choose Profile Structure in the info box. As you can see, it appears now as a custom profile in the info box. Open the settings of the profile and click on the Store Profile button to save the custom profile. Uncheck the guidelines in the Design Layers section and zoom in on the profile. As you can see, the profile has kept the settings, such that the end lines of the wall are hidden at the airspace fill. When you convert a composite to a profile, its display remains consistent. Custom defined lines and edges are retained. The profiles are now as flexible as composites. You can turn off end lines and individual cut edges as needed. When selecting a fill, you can uncheck the Show Cut End Lines checkbox in the Components Selected panel of the Profile Manager. With this option, you can hide the end contour of that component. If you check this checkbox, you can add an individual line type for the selected element, or even for all lines around the fill. Save the profile by clicking the Store Profile button. Select the custom profile in the floor plan, and from the info box, change it to the newly created profile. Let's draw a section through the profile and open it. You'll notice that the end lines of the empty fill are hidden in the floor plan as well as in the section window. Let's see one more new profile enhancement. Open the Dimension Settings dialog. In the Dimension Details panel, uncheck the Dimension Only the Core of Walls and Slabs checkbox. Click one of the profile's contours. With this option, you can dimension the entire thickness of the profile. If you check the checkbox in the Settings dialog, only the core of the profile will be dimensioned in the section as well as in the floor plan window.